Toshiko Akiyoshi was born in December 1929 in Manchuria, China. After the World War II in 1945, her family lost their home and returned to Japan, settling in Beppu when she was 6 years old. This was the time when her love for music and interest for piano started. But since the family did not have a piano, she took a job at a dance hall where she played for US soldiers. She was introduced to jazz by a local record collector when she first heard a record of Teddy Wilson playing Sweet Lorraine. Akiyoshi immediately loved the sound and began to study jazz. In 1950s, Oscar Peterson, a famous Canadian jazz pianist and composer, during his Philharmonic tour in Japan, discovered Akiyoshi playing in a club on Ginza. He convinced Akiyoshi to record for Norman Granz. And not so long after, she went to US and studied at Berklee School of Music in Boston. She was the first Japanese student at Berklee, and at Berklee, Akiyoshi studied with Herb Pomeroy and Richard Bobbitt. Her years in Boston and later in New York developed her into a first-class pianist. Her first album, 1950s, was strongly influenced by Bud Powell. Her hands are constantly in motion with high-end tinkles and flourish, while her chords are dense and majestic. Akiyoshi had lightning-fast hands and was remarkably fluent in bop. Her interest in composing and arranging rapidly thrived when she moved to Los Angeles in 1972 with her husband, saxophonist Liu Tabakian. In 1973, they formed a 16-piece big band in which Toshiko Akiyoshi composed and arranged music for the band, and her husband served as the band's featured soloist on saxophone and flutes. Besides the rootedness in bebop, her music is also strongly influenced by her heritage. She wanted to bring Japanese themes and cultural elements to her music. Toshiko took aspects of her cultural traditions she grew up with, like no and kabuki drama and other Japanese folk songs, and incorporated them into other mainstay of her life jazz. Kabuki is a classical Japanese dance drama. It is translated as the art of singing and dancing. Kabuki is designed to entertain audiences with dramatic, often spectacular effects. Akiyoshi and Tabakian like to emphasize the juxtaposition of what they call vertical rhythmic syncopation of jazz music with the sideways way Japanese music is played. Playing these elements against each other produces what many critics call an unparalleled sound in jazz. Thank you. Their album Kugan in 1974 was commercially successful in Japan. The title track, Kugan, was inspired by a story of a Japanese soldier had been discovered hiding in a cave in the Philippines, believing that the World War II had not yet ended. Kugan was recognized as one of the best-selling big band jazz albums ever. Since then, 11 albums have been issued on RCA, Jam, and Toshiko's own label. It received a 1979 Grammy nomination for Best Jazz Instrumental Performance by a Big Band.
Since then, I have been deliberately so that Minamata has no singing. Milestone pieces called Kogun, which have a suzumi player. This one.
Kogun?
Kogun.
Yeah.
This one became an all time hit in Japan. I mean, I was surprised. I thought, well, they're going to put me down because Japanese are kind of purists, you know. They don't like to put some Japanese things in it. So when I wrote that one, I said, well, are they going to put me down? And I said, go ahead and they'll do that. I don't really care. And it became an all time hit. So I was surprised.
In 1999, a Buddhist priest asked her to compose a piece for Hiroshima and sent her photos taken 3 days after the atomic bomb was dropped. She decided to write a three-part suite named Hiroshima, Rising from Abyss. It has its first performance in June 2006 at the 56th anniversary of the bombing. It received a great attention from critics around the world, not only because of its quality, but because of its subject matter. Reviewers and fans alike found the work extremely evocative, and since then, it has always been one of the most memorable performances for her band. The big band continued to grow and gain a reputation around the world as one of the most excellent and innovative big bands in Japan. Akiyoshi has frequently cited Duke Ellington as her main inspiration and major influence. Other musicians that helped her to shape her musical development include Roy Haynes, Charles Mingus, Miles Davis, and Sonny Rollins. In 2002, Toshiko retired her big band projects and returned to playing piano. She continued touring as a trio and sometimes a quartet with her husband. Summing up her own career, Toshiko commented in an interview, "I would hope that my work might have more substance and more quality rather than quantity of notes. And I hope that the notes I produce today are more selective than 20 years ago." She has always been a musical symbol of Japan, and she will always be a remarkable figure of jazz history. Thank you.